schools and secular schools. Parents find it difficult to choose a school to enroll their children. They find themselves in the dilemma of choosing the best school for their children. They do not know which is better and the one that will aid their academic performance. There are certain factors that need to be put in consideration when choosing school for awards, such as class sizes, academic quality, availability of experienced teachers, discipline, and extracurricular activities. These factors are to be put in consideration when choosing school for awards. Listen as I and my colleagues delve into expatiating on these factors one after the other. Say.
All protocol duly observed. My name is Gideon Okochukwu. I'm here to talk about the numbers of students in classroom of mission schools as opposed to that of secular schools and the absence of strike action in mission schools than in secular schools. In mission schools, there is a small and limited number of students in classroom. This allows good teacher to student relationship and give room for proper ventilation. Teachers in mission schools know both the strength and the weakness of the students. Compared to teachers in secular schools, they deal with a large class size but don't know the students in class. Absence of strike action. Strike action is the way used by trade union to protest and contest when workers are being deprived of their rights. Strike action are common to secular schools. Workers fight for increase of non-payment of salaries, which disrupt the smooth running of the academics. Strike disruption of studies are rare and absence in missionary schools. The academic session remains the same, and there's no elongation in the academic calendar except for public and federal holiday. Thank you.
All protocol duly observed. My name is Joshua Odeme. I'm here to talk about the academic performance of students in mission school over secular school. The major priority or concern of parents in Delma, whether to send their children to mission or secular school, is the level of academic performance, experienced teacher, dedicated teacher, qualified teachers have found in mission school. They teach the students well and give them the best, which make them perform better than students in secular school. This does not mean that teachers in public school are not experienced, but rather are not dedicated. They are lazy, they don't teach the students well. Most of them leave their teaching work and run to another business during school hour. This makes the students have lower academic performance. Thank you.
All protocols duly observed. My name is Joshua Stopna. I'm here to talk about academic environment and scope of teaching in mission school over secular school. Mission schools are being managed by individual churches but supervised by the state government. Mission schools have a qualitative curricular activities which are not being subject mandatory tests or scope of teaching. They have less ways of teaching their pupils and they are not stereotypic. Just in mission school, teach their children how to think critically and apply it to future. Celebrities are being reviewed after each session to make sure it's still trending the latest development in the society. Students of mission school go to go and meet with other students of high educational standard, which gives room for competition and put the level of seriousness in them. Whereas in secular school, the mission academic curriculum are being prescribed by the state government, whereby it proposes to streamline syllabuses, approve tests and exams, not minding whether the children went out or not. This does not give the teachers autonomy to choose out of the scope laid down by the government. Teachers in mission schools use one-to-one approach to impart knowledge in the student's life to sort out individual differences. This type of approach is not obtainable in secular school. Thank you.
All protocol daily observe. My name is Light Bay. I'm here to talk about the motion research in mission school than in secular school. Mission school have a high standard of discipline and morals. Students with discipline problems are fewer in mission school than in secular school. This is because 1. Mission school have a way of scrutinizing students before admitting them. 2. They have rules of conduct that must be strictly adhered by all students. And if anyone defaults, he will be dealt with appropriately. And this goes a long way in shaping the child to be better individual. Secular school, on the other hand, accept almost every student that comes to the school. They have problems in dealing and dealing with undisciplined students and do not have a great authority to continue their enrollment. Unlike in mission school, whereby students who do not abide by the rules and codes of conduct are being expelled by morals, as it is written in Proverbs 22 verses, and it says, train up a child in the way he should go, and when he's old, he will never depart from it. Thank you.
Our protocol duly observed. My name is Success Uba. I'm here to talk about engagement in extracurricular activities in mission schools over secular schools. One of the factors that contribute to academic engaging in social activities like sport, athletic, and club, the popular thing. All works and no play make junk. Boy, explains the importance of extracurricular activities. Important factor is the availability of these facilities. These facilities may be available in both mission schools and secular schools. Some schools have sport facilities such as swimming pool, basketball, and football pitch, but do not make use of it. This is common in secular schools, where the available facilities are not taken care of nor maintained. On the other hand, mission schools still give the best of the social and sport facilities. Interhouses have been organized, whereby students are randomly distributed into different houses to compete with one another. This serves as a way of promoting unity among the students, keep body fit, improve and develop their skills or talent. All these are essential prerequisites to academic excellence. Thank you.
My beloved brethren and guardians, friends and well wishes, you've heard it all. In conclusion, I want to add by saying that here in our mission school, we're set with God first by meeting the physical and spiritual needs of our students. Discipline, teachers' dedication to work, qualified teachers, adequate learning facilities, and a conducive studying environment are part of the factors that make up our success story. We want to use this opportunity to thank God for using our beloved daddy and mommy for putting all these factors in place and for upgrading my school to an international standard. Parents, do not enroll your children in school with faulty spiritual and educational foundation to avoid regrets in future. I want to use this medium to invite you to enroll your children and work with us at Chosen International School, number 10 to 12 Mobanjumala Street, near Kawaj Bus Stop, Ikotu, and other Chosen Schools nationwide. To ensure qualitative education in my school, we engage in excursions and field trips. That's not all. My school also has a healthy and friendly atmosphere. Oh, I love my school. God bless our beloved dad and mommy for upgrading my school. Thank you. Our core values at Chosen International School equal to are excellence,
integrity, commitment,
creativity,
motivation,
respect,
and teamwork.
Let's appreciate God for the presentation of these children. Children of